انتهاء حمدا ليس بعده حمد تبارك وتعالى الله رب العالمين والصلاة على نبيه المصطفى ورسوله الأوفى ورحمته الكبرى وصاحب الشفاعة المرتجى محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم.
اللهم صل على محمد
وعلى أهل بيته المعصومين سفن النجاة ومنائر الهدى. السلام على رسول الله، السلام على خيرة الله، السلام على البشير النذير، السلام على السراج المنير ورحمة الله وبركاته، السلام على الطهر الطاهر، السلام على العلم الزاهر، السلام على المنصور المؤيد، السلام على أبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآله.
السلام على أمير المؤمنين ويعسوب الدين وقائد الغر المحجلين علي بن أبي طالب. السلام على سيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام. السلام على علي بن الحسين، السلام على محمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد وحسن بن علي ومحمد بن الحسن المهدي عجل الله فرجه الشريف.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
قال سيدنا ومولانا إمام الصادق عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام: امتحنوا شيعتنا عند مواقيت الصلاة كيف محافظتهم عليها، وإلى أسرارنا كيف حفظهم لها عند عدونا، وإلى أموالهم كيف مواساتهم لإخوانهم فيها. إمام الصادق عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام describes the characteristics of a Shia believer and the Shia of Ahlul Bayt عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام. He starts off by saying that you know a Shia, a follower of Ahlul Bayt, by how he corresponds with the times of his prayers. If he prays on time or he does not pray on time. This is what makes a person a Shia of Ahlul Bayt. And if he does not correspond and he is not responsible of the times of his prayers, then he should not consider him as a Shia himself, as a Shia of Ahlul Bayt alayhum afdal as-salatu was-salam. The first attribute a Shia of Ahlul Bayt salamullahi alayhum must carry is that he prays on time, brothers and sisters. On time, when as soon as adhan is raised and as soon as it is time for prayer, you leave everything behind. From your family to your business, everything, from your television, even if it's the Euro Cup, you leave it behind and you stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you establish the connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the hadith of the attributes of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, if he would hear the adhan, his face would become pale and yellow, and he would leave his family members, he would leave his wives and run towards the masjid. He would leave everything behind, he would become pale. And when they asked him, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, why do we see you become so nervous every time when the call of prayer is called or raised? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi says in a response that why should I not be if I will stand in front of the most powerful creator, Amam Jabbaru Samawati wal Ard, the most powerful. Oh, I'm standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maliki Yawmiddin, the king of the day of judgment, the one who separates people from heaven or hell. I'm standing in front of my creator. So as a Shia believer, if we want to carry characteristics of Ahlul Bayt alayhum afdal as-salatu was-salam, we should always recognize the times of prayers. And also I would like to use the last part of the hadith of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam. You are not a Shia if you do not aid your brothers and sisters with your money and your wealth. If you know there's a brother in your community, he was weak and he needs help, don't consider yourself a Shia and a lover of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam unless you're holding one another's backs. You're helping one another. You're helping each other. You're asking one another what you need. What can I help you with, my dear brother, my dear sister? Are you having trouble paying your mortgage? Are you having trouble lifting your business? These are the characteristics of the Shia of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam. And another hadith by Imam al-Baqir alayhi as-salam, Ya Aba al-Maqdam, إنما شيعة عليه السلام الشاحبون الناحلون الذابلون ذابل شفاههم خميص بطونهم متغير ألوانهم مصفر وجوههم إذا جنهم الليل اتخذوا الأرض فراشا واستقبلوا الأرض بجباههم كثير سجودهم كثيرة دموعهم كثير دعاؤهم كثير بكاؤهم يفرح الناس وهم محزنون. Do we have these characteristics that Imam al-Baqir alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam is telling one of his companions by the name of Miqdam? He tells him, O Miqdam, the Shia of Ali ibn Abi Talib are not the ones who eat and have all the strength. No, they're the ones who spend all their energy in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their lips have become pale. They have moved down because of the amount of tasbih that they make on daily occasions. Every time you see them, they're making tasbih. Their lips are moving and the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِذَا جَنَّهُمُ اللَّيْلِ اتَّخَذُوا الْأَرْضَ فِرَاشًا. If night would come and night came, they wouldn't sleep in their beds. They would move to the floor and they would sit on their prayer rugs. And they would spend their nights on their prayer rugs until they slept. And sleepiness came to their eyes. وَاسْتَقْبَلُوا الْأَرْضَ بِجِبَابِهِمْ. And they placed their foreheads. They faced the earth with their foreheads. كَثِيرٌ سُجُودُهُمْ. You always see them in a lot of prostration and sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَثِيرَةٌ دُمُوعُهُمْ. You always see him crying and pleading to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, for the times that he wasted, for the sins that he committed, for the mistakes that he made. كَثِيرٌ دُعَاؤُهُمْ. You see them holding the Mafatih al-Jinan, reciting the du'as of Ahlul Bayt عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام. كَثِيرٌ بُكَاؤُهُمْ يَفْرَحُ النَّاسُ وَهُمْ مَحْزُونُونَ. You see the people, they are happy, they're living their life, but these people, they're not by this world. They're sad and sorrow of what awaits them when it comes to their grave. What awaits them as soon as they depart this life. These are the Shia of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And another hadith, دَخَلْتُ عَلَى الصَّادِقِ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ وَعَنْدَهُ نَفَرٌ مِّنَ الشِّيعَ وَهُوَ يَقُولُ مَعَاشِرَ الشِّيعَ كُولُوا لَنَا زَيْنًا وَلَا تَكُونُوا عَلَيْنَا شَيْنًا قُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حَسَنًا وَاحْفَظُوا أَلْسِنَتُكُمْ وَكَفُّوهَا عَنِ الْفُضُولِ. The Shia are not the ones who badmouth. The Shias are not the ones who curse. The Shia are those who have the most humbling of words, most beautiful of words. The Shia, Imam al-Sadiq alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam, if you consider yourself a Shia, be an ornament to Ahlul Bayt. So when people see you, they say, these are the Shia of Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq. These people with noble characteristics, these generous people that give back to the community. And do not be people who destroy our image. So at the end of the day, they come and say, look at these people. They have no manners, they have no characteristics. And these are the Shia of Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam. We are the representatives of Amir al-Mu'mineen. We are the representatives of Imam al-Hasan. We are the representatives of Imam al-Husayn in this country, in this land. We are the representatives. And if you want to be considered a Shia and a representative of Ahlul Bayt, alayhum afdalu salati wa salam, Imam al-Sadiq says, Ma'ashir al-Shia, kulu lana zaynan, wa la takunu alayna shayna. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih, اتقوا الله معاشر الشيعة فإن الجنة لن تفوتكم وإن أبطأت بها عنكم قبائح أعمالكم فتنافسوا في درجاتها. All the Shia of Amir al-Mu'mineen, do not fear that you will not enter paradise. But I told you the characteristics of the Shia. If you don't carry these characteristics, then you are just merely a lover, a devotee to Ahlul Bayt, alayhim afdal as-salatu was-salam. But if you want to have this purified title, this significant title, this perfect title of being a Shia of Ahlul Bayt, alayhim afdal as-salatu was-salam, you must carry the characteristics that I mentioned by the words of Ahlul Bayt, alayhim afdal as-salatu was-salam. Rasulullah says that paradise will not pass you. You will eventually see paradise, but it might take a long time because of your sins. And how can we withstand the fires of Jahannam, brothers and sisters? أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي الخاطئة بتقوى الله. We must fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear the day of judgment. نار تقودها النار والحجارة ناس والحجارة. This fire, it's fuel, it fuels on the flesh of human beings. We do not want to be part of this fuel, brothers and sisters. To be surrounded by fires, fires that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for punishment, not for you to cook your food with, for punishment. So we must realize that our sins will delay us. They will place us in places where we do not want to be on the day of judgment, with those who we do not want to be with on the day of judgment. Let's make our imams proud. Let's make Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi proud. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi says, فَتَنَافَسُوا فِي دَرَجَاتِهَا. Race, make your obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a race. We shouldn't race of how much money we make, or how big our houses are, or how nice our cars are and how luxurious they are, but how much we present to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the darajat, the positions that we will earn on the day of judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the shafa'ah of Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad in this world, their ziyarah in this world, and their intercession in the akhirah. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.